Greetings, 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 and salutations, one and all. Welcome, 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 welcome to the night shift. It is a brand spanking new night shift. Personal night shift year, I should call it. It's a brand spanking new week right here on the night shift with DJ Kim and Stu. And it's a night where we do a thing we call community and finance. Greetings and salutations to each and every one of you. Welcome to the show. Big ups to all those who have it locked, those who have it on TuneIn Radio, night shift to DJ Kim and Stu, Rattlebox.net, the Foundation Radio Network, One Harmony Radio. Whoever, wherever you are in the world, big ups, big ups, big ups, big ups to you. Glad to have you. Couldn't do it without you, and I promise you, I won't try.
Yeah. Lyrical, girl, steal my heart like a criminal. Okay, okay, okay.
Lyrical, Patrice Roberts, okay, okay. Mill Beats. The track is called Criminal Wine.
I go see for wine like a criminal. No resistance, shot to be minimal. Lock your dumb and wine like a criminal. Like a criminal, like a criminal. Stick it up and wine like a criminal. Man, no fears, there's time for your physical. Lock your dumb and wine like a criminal. Like a criminal, like a criminal.
I want to say thanks to Pulse Media Group for sponsoring this segment of the show. When being in the moment is priceless, you want to give them a call. 754-999-6020. Or you can hit them up at pulseemg.com. Visit the website, yeah? Number to call, numbers to text to get you in touch. I encourage you to call more than to text. 773-789-STEW. There's just something about this song that just... I don't know, it's just criminal. I want to say big ups to those in the stew pot. The place where we keep things bubbling. What's the stew pot, you may ask? Where can I find it? The stew pot is on kevinstew.com. And it's that place where we interact and mix things up. In a a good way, of course.
Like a criminal.
It's otherwise known as the chat room.
Yeah. Like a criminal. Yeah. Poetry's a lyrical. Oh yeah. Say I love you, girl. Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
You roll up on me like you don't have a
girl. On the phone line, we have the man himself. The one and only, our legal advisor to the diaspora, Mr. Owen K.Ferguson. Owen, you there? Oh, you're there, but not here. You know, there's something about some of these devices sometimes that it just baffles the mind. But he's here now. The gremlins are still alive and well. I want to thank you each and everyone for your Earth Date greetings and best wishes. I did truly full joy my vacation and my Earth Date celebrations. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Big ups to my brethren, host of Real Rockers, Mr. Marlon Burrell. Wicked show once again. Thank you for the Earth Date greetings and big ups, sir. Much respect, my brother. Enough love. Owen. How you doing, bro?
Yeah, Kev, I'm doing all right. I'm good. How are you? Still celebrating?
All month.
Why not?
All month. I want to say big ups to guest 217 in the pot. Big ups to you. How is Jamaica? I must say, the little bit that I saw of Jamaica last week, I missed home so much. I passed through Otarius for a quick drop in on Wednesday.
Okay.
I was there just for a few hours and loved every minute of it.
Nice.
I must say it. For real, for real, for real. But I hear there was some flooding down on Mandela.
Yeah, so we have, if our listeners remember, the Mandela traverses what was formerly the Duhane River. And every now and again, when there is heavy rainfall, that river returns and impinges on the roadway. And because the roadway is fairly low relative to the river.
Right.
And granted, for most of the year, that is a dry riverbed or very, very low level of water. But certainly, when there's heavy rainfall, the level rises and threatens the roadway. So yes, there was some blockage in that area today.
Mm. Well, I hope that all runs off real quick. Because
yes, and beyond that, I believe the work that's now being done out there will raise the road sufficiently. I'm hoping it will. From what I've seen, it seems that it will raise the road sufficiently so that that doesn't remain an issue for much longer.
Okay, we'll see how that works out. And of course, if anybody has relatives and friends in California, there is the fires out there. That just whoa. Spoke to my sister earlier. She is affected by the smoke from the fires. She lives out that side. And the Salvation Army has a campsite that lost some excuse me. That lost some land to the fire. And one building that I know of also. So yeah, things happening. Prayers going out to those in California. All right, so Owen, what's going on with you? What's up? What do you have in store for us tonight?
All right, so we're doing good. This evening I want to return to a topic that is of great interest to persons living outside of Jamaica. We continue to get queries in the office on this subject, and that is adverse possession. So real quickly, what it means is that for a property owner who for an extended period has not paid attention to their property, it could very well be that someone here in Jamaica could take possession of that property and ultimately apply for and be issued with title to that land as the new owner. That's entirely lawful, because the law assumes that a property owner who has effectively abandoned the property, no longer interested, or in some cases may have died or moved away, then without the law of adverse possession, those plots of land would remain unavailable. So the law provides that after a passage of time, a new person in possession, exercising the rights of an owner and demonstrating that they're in open, uncontested possession of the land, can in fact apply and be granted possession, granted title to the land as the new owner. So adverse possession, always controversial, but it's very much a live part of the law.
That's pretty much the Capture Land Act.
Okay.
Okay. I don't know any other way to phrase it, to term it.
Yeah, so it has been referred to like that. And in many ways that's how it occurs. You know, people encroach on your land,
mm-hmm.
And ultimately dispossess the lawful owner of it. Now, what can you do as a landowner? What can you do? And it's a couple of things.
Mm.
One, just continue to pay attention to the property. You know, continue to visit, have someone who is local check on the property,
mm-hmm.
To the extent that you can fence the property, put up signs on the property, private property, no trespassing, that sort of thing, and do a periodic check of the property, have a trusted third party walk the land and ensure that there's no one encroaching on it. Mm-hmm. And if they are, you know, you give them proper notice, etc., and have them removed. Now, how does one establish claim to land by way of adverse possession?
Yes.
The applicant must show that they have been open possession of the land for a minimum period of 12 years in respect of registered land. It means that they would have been occupying the land under no proper title, not as a tenant, not as a lessee, simply having gone onto the land and possessed the land as an owner in an uncontested way for 12 continuous years. They can then, at the end of that 12-year period, apply to have themselves noted as the legal owner of the land. Now, this period must be unbroken and uncontested. So if at any point during that period the lawful owner returns,
mm-hmm.
or makes a claim on the land in some way, and puts up a sign, builds a fence, has their agents come by and, you know, address the occupant.
Plant a tree, pull up a tree.
Effectively breaks, yes. All the acts that would be expected of an owner. So in other words, the law recognizes the acts and says, no, what are the activities that are occurring on the land and who is it that is doing the activities? And the law seeks to, reward is a strong word.
Mm-hmm.
The law recognizes the person who is operating as the owner of the land.
Right.
And the law effectively requires you to be an active owner. Or you could very well find yourself dispossessed of the land.
And this activity only needs to happen once in this 12-year period?
Only once. But of course, we recommend that it is continuous, because there could be multiple attempts, you know, over time.
Yeah.
So just periodically take a trip down, you know, have some workmen go through and clear up the place, put up signs, put up a fence, you know, give proper notice to members of the community that you're still the owner of the land, still showing interest, and still interested in using, perhaps not immediately, but, you know, ensure that especially the immediate neighbors know that you are still the owner. Importantly, but not exclusively, it's important that you also continue to pay the taxes on the land.
Right.
So that's also expected of an owner. And if someone else goes ahead and does that and uses that among other things, but it's never just that. People sometimes think that once you're paying the taxes, that's a conclusive proof that you're the owner. Absolutely not.
Because
so it's several acts which taken together demonstrate that you are operating as the owner of the land.
So if you own a land, I end up going to squat on it, for argument's sake, and decide that after 3 years I realize that you're not paying any taxes, and I start paying taxes. So now, over this 10-year period, for 7 out of it, I was paying taxes on the land, and year 11, you just show up out of the blue and pay 1 year tax. That mash up all my plans. That destroys every little bit of plans that I was scheming to have in owning that land.
Yes. Yeah, so it interrupts the 12-year period, and that would restart at that point. So once you are in contact with the land in a meaningful way as owner, and then it would interrupt any claim that an applicant would have. Now, importantly, as I think I mentioned it before, but let me just underline this point. In doing an application for adverse possession, the person who's applying needs to show by way of testimony from neighbors that they are in fact operating as owner. So, which is why I've said to you, if it is you're overseas, for instance, and you visit, ensure that you make contact with the neighbors and persons in the community to say, yes, you're still the owner of the land, you still have interest in the land, you have plans for it, so that those individuals can't serve as witnesses for anyone else who's not going to go forward to say, you know, they haven't seen the owner, they don't know who is the owner, the grandfather died and nobody knows where the children or grandchildren are, kind of a thing. Ensure that you touch base with, you know, every community has a little village lawyer, somebody who is highly regarded.
Ensure that
you stay in close touch with those people and confirm with them that you still intend to make use of the land going forward.
Yeah,
that's very, very important.
Because that can be quite rough. We are familiar with individuals who have decided that they're going to set up shop, so to speak, on other people's land, and when the other people show up to do whatever they decide to do on their land, now they have a hard time because these people are claiming this land. So then, of course, that's how the fight started.
Right.
But how then does one go about reclaiming ownership of their land? Not that they have lost it, but these squatters have decided that they want to pirate the thing.
Right. So, again, you're ensuring that you make yourself known as still the owner of the land. And you carry out acts which are consistent with ownership of land. You go there and you till the soil, you plant up something, you build a fence, you repaint the building, whatever, if there's a building on it.
You
generally show interest in the land in a way that makes it clear that you are the owner. And I keep saying land, but it could, of course, be land with buildings or any other
type of property.
So demonstrate by various acts, some examples of which I've given, that you are the owner of the land and you're operating as someone who is owner, which would include some of the acts that we listed.
Right.
Maintaining it, paying the taxes, and importantly, keeping others out. Just taking steps to keep other people off your land, such as fencing, such as putting up animals on it, and other such acts. Have persons on your behalf do this if it is that you're far away and you're not able to visit. Have trusted people go there and ensure that they declare that, boy, this is DJ Kevin Land and don't interfere with it. He's coming back for it. He wants it and then plant it up, etc., etc. And
what if people decide that they're going to have their animals on your land?
Right. So once you learn of it, we give warning to individuals who are doing it. Send out a message in the community, but you don't know exactly who is doing it. But I hear that some goat is on my place. Tell them to come out. And, you know, you make contact, as I said, with the key people in the community.
Right.
Who have influence and who can support you on that.
Okay. But can I take a course of action to say, well, they're on my land, so they're my property?
The animals?
Yes.
Well, no, not strictly speaking, no. Because it's not quite that simple.
You know, it's kind of like the mango tree is on your property, but it's hungover on my side and beer. You know?
Yes. I see the parallel you're going for, but it's not quite so. But yeah, you do want to ensure that you keep the land free from animals and from shrubbery and that sort of thing. You maintain the land in a way that demonstrates that you are owner. So it's, the law looks at acts of ownership. Some of the creative as examples. There's no complete list of what an act of ownership is, but typically it would involve some of the things that we just discussed: keeping others out, maintaining the look and feel of the property, and ensuring that it is kept in good condition.
Right.
And by doing so, you would have maintained your claim as an owner, even though you are miles and miles away.
I've always looked at issues like that and wondered, you know, the course of action that is lawful to take. Because, of course, you put up a sign that says trespassers. Well, some signs coming out of Jamaica read along the lines of trespassers will be prostituted, trespassers will be persecuted. really and truly, trespassers will be prosecuted. But outside of that, what kind of action can an individual just get up and take outside of bringing in a representative of the law? If they post a sign, are they in a position to say, okay, they're trespassed, I can deal with it as I see fit and then report it?
All right, so you're getting into another area of the law, right? For instance, as you mentioned, you know.
Yeah, I know. And I know that we don't have much time to get into it, but maybe that's another side that needs addressing.
So you can, in fact, by way of the notice, take action to remove the animals, let's say. But you certainly are not empowered simply by, as an owner, to retain the animals.
Okay.
So the law expects you to make all efforts to identify who the owner is and the animals.
So, all right. Can I let me suggest this then? How about we look at the rights of the owner under the law as it relates to property? Right. Sound like a plan?
Yeah, for sure, absolutely.
Okay.
You know, that's always going to be an era for owners to exercise their full benefit and use of the land.
Okay. So that is what we'll attack come next week. All being well. Since you brought this back up, and that thought has always been in my head. And things don't stay in my head for long, so I put it out there so that other people can hold on to it and bring it back to me. So, Owen, you are now officially charged with the responsibility of bringing that back up next week. All right, so Owen, just give out your contact information for me, please, for those who have property in Jamaica and may be having some issues or just want to catch up.
Right, so it's Owen K. Ferguson at hotmail.com. On the telephone is 876-840-5862. That's 876-840-5862. And that's the voice as well as WhatsApp. So, yeah, communicate by that.
All right. I thank you, my brethren. Truly appreciate it. Well, I really appreciate love it. All being well, we'll be connecting again come next week. I know this time change kind of threw us off tonight. The time change happened last week, and because I didn't do a show last week, it kind of threw us off a little bit earlier. But we're on the same, literally, on the same timeline right now. So, come next week, 10 o'clock, we're back on it again.
Okay, bro.
All right. Give my love to the family. Take care, bro. Be safe. All right. We're going to take a quick little break. When we come back, it's all about the man that says, bless me. Stick and stay, or bring some people along. Let's chat. Tenor Blue comes up in just a few. Hey, that rhymes. Tenor Blue in just a few. We'll be right back.
Quality Media Group, innovative streaming and recording, has done it again. A new way to get your business in full view of your neighborhood consumer through AdShare TV. It's available in your neighborhood today. It's easy. Just call us, 754-999-6020. Become a host today and place a TV monitor in a strategic location so it's easy to see. Get a 1-minute video ad or longer that plays anywhere in our network. Can't be a host? No problem. For a few dollars, we'll run your 30-second video ad. A host can run announcement specials like buy one, get one free, or discount ads. Let's turn your flyers into a 30-second video with music, or a voiceover, or let us create and run your video ad with a spokesperson. Take advantage of our early enrollment discount. Join us today. Your ad will be seen at least 30 times per day in your AdShare TV neighborhood. It's easy. Just call us, 754-999-6020. AdShare TV, part of Pulse Media Group.
Are you crazy about the music industry? You aspire to hit it big in music? Or maybe you've sweated out a soulful killer beat and are now stuck finding it's not as easy as it looked? Oh, but it can be easy for you with JTMC. We've been there, we know how it feels. So we solve challenges like production, promotion, marketing, branding and development, and more. With over 30 years of experience, JTMC is a one-stop shop for artists. We handle your graphic design, writing services, PR, as well as event planning, e-blasts, artist management, and bookings, so also your website and social media needs as well. We're experts in using creativity to persuade audiences on behalf of artists, drawing on our diverse experience to create projects that connect with audiences intellectually and emotionally. Artist success is everything to us, and our years of experience and commitment will be behind you for every one of your needs. If you've got music for the world to hear, whether you're a new or established artist, visit us at jtmcenterprise.com.
Roll out with Island Rock Music and have fun. Check out the quality apparel at islandrockmusic.com. Designed for you and your crew. Hear the music, feel the breeze, with selected tracks and more. Available now from the online store at islandrockmusic.com. islandrockmusic.com. Log on today and ride with us.
Stepping. These are roots vibrations.
We're off to an early start for a long, hot summer, but beat the heat with a dash of lemongrass refresher. This cool thirst quencher is a low-sugar beverage made from the fevergrass plant, which has antioxidants, several wellness properties, and is a great lifestyle drink for all ages. Ah, that hits the spot. It's a new great taste. Have one today. Dash Lemongrass Refresher, distributed by Carib Atlantic Distributors. Call 954-614-0919. That's 954-614-0919. Life's a dash. Live well.
Matthew 28:19 says, "Go ye therefore and teach all nations." With this in mind, and encouragement received during a South Florida media conference, The Church Links was birthed. The Church Links is an interdenominational worship service portal for churches, providing the tools to spread the word through technology in a cost-effective way. The Church Links. www.dahchurchlinx.com. Your links to worship and praise.
It's Christine representing for DJ Kevin. You see me, I say, I don't know the boss. You see me, I say, DJ Kevin's two and the night shift radio show. Yo, the thing turn up, the thing loud. Whoa! DJ Kevin's true of the heart of a champion. Never underestimate, just choose him. The silver line behind the dark clouds. DJ Kevin's true, believe him, and that's no doubt. Salute the night shift radio show, Christine. It's a heart attack. Loud. Kill the beast.
Another day slip away. Time is always moving, so you'd better not wait. Every day is precious, I don't wanna be late. When there's love to brighten up our lives, can we keep it real? Cause I don't wanna pretend. I've been thinking about us being more than just friends. You don't wanna wake up all alone and regret, and find the chance for us has passed you by. Bless me with your smile. Bless me with that look of love. I see it in your eyes. Girl, don't test me, cause I won't compromise. Just do me right and I'll be there today. To bless you with my time. Bless you with my heart and all the stuff I have inside. Let me take you where happiness abides, and let me chase our troubles all away. Your girlfriends, well, that may not be wise. They know nothing about me and they're telling you lies, saying you'll find better any day. I ain't got tattoos and I don't drive fancy cars. Keep it down to earth and got my head in the stars. You'll search far and wide, but you'll find no bigger heart than the one in front of you today. Bless me with your smile. Bless me with that look of love. I see it in your eyes. Girl, don't test me, I won't compromise. Just do me right and I'll be there today. To bless you with my time. Bless you with my heart and all the stuff I have inside. Let me take you where everything's alright. chase our troubles all away.
I want to say thank you to GMAT Music Solutions for sponsoring this segment of the show. Welcome back to all those who have been here from the beginning. Welcome to those who are just joining in.
I need for front, girl. Hey, cause I know something, girl, that we all want love. Yeah, we all need love. So get your head out of the
in the background. Track called Bless Me.
Cause love it ain't no crime. Bless me, bless me with
vocal stylings of a man called Tenor Blue.
In your eyes, you don't test me. Cause I want the eyes just to be bad and I'll be it.
I want to say welcome to the pot, guest 407.
Bless you with my time. Bless you with my heart and all this love I have inside. Let me take you in.
A jumbo jet of a listener, I guess 777.
Bless me.
Not calling you big, but I'm pretty sure that you're large and in charge. And with me on the phone line, the man of the hour. The actual owner of that voice to the track you just heard. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you for the first time on the night shift, Mr. Tenor Blue.
DJ Kevin Stu, how are you?
Choo choo choo. Hey, we're rapping around here. We're rapping around here. Hope people understand. Tenor Blue, welcome to the show, bro. How you doing?
I'm great. Thank you for having me, man. It's good to be here.
Man, I've been waiting for this.
Yeah, I'm guilty as charged.
You know, but nothing happens before it's time.
True indeed. And I'm here now.
Yes.
So we're going to make the most of it.
Definitely. Marlon healing you up in the pot. In fact, Marlon, at the end of his show, he was playing this song. Bless nice. Me. This song getting a nice little vibe, you know. people enjoying it. It just, it borderline reggae gospel and lovers rock.
Lovers rock, little touch of R&B. It's kind of island reggae, you know.
Yeah,
it's what I call island reggae. What's going on out there today?
Well, is there another kind of reggae? Isn't it all island reggae?
Well, yeah, but you know, the funny thing is when they talk about island reggae, that expression and that kind of subgenre of reggae is applied to Hawaiian, South Pacific sound, some of the Southern California. So we're talking about acts like, you know, Jay Boog and Fiji and Common Kings and Sammy Johnson. And, you know, if the listeners are familiar with these acts. So that, you know, I feel like that song kind of falls into that lane.
Okay, gotcha.
Yeah.
Well, I say big ups to hashtag happy jumping into the pot. You see, only you can bring out some people, you know. I haven't seen hashtag happy in the pot. I know that she's been tuning in, but I haven't seen her. I know you've dragged her out.
All right. Well, hopefully some of that happy dust will rub off on us. Huh?
Listen, all she needs to do is show up. She doesn't even have to be there the whole time. She just needs to show up, and it's just happiness.
Beautiful.
All over.
Well, welcome aboard, happy. Nice to have you.
All right. So... Tenor Blue. Who is Tenor Blue? Let's start from the tippy top.
Well, the big question. You know, Tenor Blue is a conscious man, a lover, and a lover of music, and the stuff that I do as an artist really sort of encapsulates a heart of love with a love of God and a quest to ever improve and grow as a human being and to be more righteous, more godlike. And so, you know, I think when I sit down and I write, my music sort of ranges between that lover's rock vibe and conscious tunes that really deal with and focus on the realities of the human experience, right? And the things that we all as human beings deal with, sometimes that aren't always fun or pleasant, but they're the reality of the human experience, right? And so, I'm not afraid to touch on those things. So you know, as an artist, as a human being, man, we all go through ups and downs and good times and bad times and happiness and struggles. And so, you know, for every mood, there's a song, you know, to take you there. And so that's really what I try to do, is just sink into wherever I'm at in life and whatever I'm seeing in the world that's moving me or touching me or even getting me upset, get my blood boiling, right? It could be things that I'm seeing in the world.
Stimulating the emotion at that time.
Correct. And then I sit down and I just try to get lost in that vibe and that feeling and create something that speaks to my heart. And I feel like if I do that, then it's a good chance it's going to speak to somebody else as well.
All right. So at what point in your life, let's get to the story of Tenor Blue.
Mm-hmm.
Because first of all, when I first saw and heard you, it was in the garden, I would say maybe 2 years ago, could have been three.
Okay.
In the garden, Code Red brought you on stage, Code Red Band.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And I saw you walk up and I was like, okay, this is going to be interesting. And then you started to sing. And I don't think there was a surface inside that club that did not get a fist, a palm, a bottle, something. Everybody was beating something the moment you started singing. So for those of you not watching on kevinstew.com and don't know what Tenor Blue looks like, you can pretty much tell from the sound of the voice that Tenor Blue is by no stretch of the imagination someone that looks like me. Tenor Blue is this quite Caucasian man. And when you see him walk up into a club that's predominantly filled with Jamaicans, and we come in all shapes, sizes, and races, but you hear him come in and he greets everybody the way you hear him, and then he starts singing the way you heard Bless Me. But that wasn't the song he was singing. He went into some real old school reggae. And I was like, this man here is just wearing a suit. Who is this under this suit? Where is the gimmicks? What's going on here? Where did you grow up? How did you grow up? What introduced you to... Where was the introduction to reggae music?
Right,
did you grow up in Jamaica? Did you grow up with Jamaicans?
I sure didn't grow up in Jamaica, nor did I grow up with Jamaicans. So the story is this. I grew up in San Francisco, California.
Mm-hmm.
And from before I could speak, you know, and I'm sharing what I've been told by my parents.
Right.
In my home, I would ask my father to play records all the time. So I was drawn in to music from before I could speak. And when I got to, I would say, you know, 5 years old or 6 years old, I started collecting records. You know, Michael Jackson, Jackson 5 stuff. And I remember some of the first records I got my hands on, Earth, Wind, and Fire. And, you know, I was listening to Stevie Wonder and Marvin Gaye were still, you know, making music and had, you know, were big names. And this was just the stuff that I was drawn to as a kid. And I just loved that soulful vibe. And that was not what was being played in my home. So, you know, I didn't grow up in a house. I didn't grow up in the church singing. I didn't grow up in a, you know, I grew up in a white home. And my parents listened to a lot of different music, but it wasn't black music per se. Mm-hmm. But for whatever reason, that's what I loved. That's what I was drawn to. And I just, you know, music was a part of my life from as long as I can remember. So, you know, if we fast forward and okay. So there, when a couple of my best friends growing up, one of my close buddies, his parents, I remember, would play reggae in the home. So I'm say 9 years old, 10 years old. Okay. We're hearing reggae in my friend's house, and you know we kind of used to crack jokes about it, and we were like, well, you know, what is this? Like we weren't feeling it. You know, we were all on the same stuff. We were listening to R&B, you know, soul music. So
right.
When I got to high school, my father worked with a Jamaican, mm-hmm. and he and I became friendly. He was older than me, of course, and he got to know my interest in music and my tastes. And he said one day, he said, look, let me loan you a couple CDs, and I want you to check this stuff out, and you tell me what you think. So he brought into the office when I came by to visit my pop. He brought a Black Uhuru album. Mm-hmm. And he brought a Bob Marley album. Okay. And so, you know, I had been, like I said, I was introduced to a little, you know, you knew who Bob Marley was. He was an international superstar.
Right.
But I never really paid it much attention or much mind. So I took those CDs and sat down and listened to them. And that changed my life, because I guess I was just ready for that music at that stage in my life. But my mind was blown, and I just fell into that drum and bass and that deep reggae groove, and
yes,
just
the
roots feeling of those records. And of course, those were some rootsy records, because I think it was Black Uhuru's Chill Out album, if I remember correctly, and Bob Marley album, I think, was Naughty Dread. And so, you know, I came back to him and I said, "What is this? I want more." So I ended up starting to just go out, and you know, in a city like San Francisco, you know, there's record stores all over the place.
Right.
You can get exposed to a lot. It's a pretty cosmopolitan city, and people are very open-minded and musical tastes and all that stuff. So I just started to, you know, look for whatever I could get my hands on. And so the Bob Marley and the Black Uhuru led to Third World and Steel Pulse and Dennis Brown and Gregory Isaacs, and it just sort of snowballed, you know. And you know, to answer your question, Kevin, it's like, you know, what is it, you know, not being a Jamaican, coming from a white home, you know, what made me so attracted to soul music? What made me at that stage in my life so attracted to reggae? I don't know. I don't know what to tell you now, but it was something that was deep inside me and was, you know, it was bound to happen. And so I just fell in love with the music, man, and you know, got more and more and more involved in listening and studying and figuring out what was going on. And then years later, I started to, you know, got to a point where I started hearing melodies and words bubbling up inside me and decided it was time for me to start, you know, playing around and seeing if I could write something.
So that's interesting, though, because the reggae bug bit you in high school, and the writing bug bit you round about what, 4 years later,
As I was finishing college. So I went from San Francisco down to Los Angeles.
Okay.
Where I finished college. And it was really towards the end of college. So I'm in my early 20s. And, you know, now I'm like really deep into reggae. And, you know, I'm picking up, you know, singles with versions on them and stuff like that. And that was really the thing, was like getting the versions. And like, mm-hmm. you know, I was, you know, it could have been, you know, Sugar Minot or whomever with these records. And I'm like hearing these records and I'm like, okay, you know, I'm hearing some of my own stuff on these versions. So that was really where the thing started. And I always knew I could sing, you know, but it was just something where I got to that age where those creative juices started to flow. And I was mature enough to be able to start, you know, writing about things that, you know, had some merit or were, you know, were worth writing lyrics to. And, you know, so I just started to try my hand and create some stuff. They were simple tunes, you know, nice melodies and some cool lyrics and stuff, and just started demoing things as I wrote them. And I would share them with people and people would respond. So that's really where the thing started, was just, you know, trying to play around and realizing, you know, there was something decent there, and then just continuing to work on it.
So you said you always knew you could sing. Does that mean that you dibbled and dabbled with a little voice training, or this is all just natural?
I had some vocal training as a kid. There was a family friend mm-hmm. who was a jazz vocalist, and I took a few lessons, but I never really did much with it. I think the thing was, is it was just like, I knew I had a nice tone, and I knew I had, you know, kind of a deep affinity and connection with music.
Right.
And sort of a melodic, you know, a sense of melody, you know? And so, but, you know, you play around, you sing in the shower, you do whatever. It's like, you know, you can kind of figure, unless you're just, you know, somebody who's just outright lies to themselves, you know.
It's nice singing a show, and I can tell you, I would sound nothing like this on a recording.
Yeah, so you know, it was like, you know, I knew that there was a gift. You know, I knew that there was something there, that God had given me a voice and, you know, an ear for music. Right. But I just never, as a kid growing up, like I said, I didn't grow up in the church, and I did not, and I was kind of shy about it. I didn't know what to do with it, you know. And it wasn't, I didn't grow up in a home of musicians, and, you know, so it wasn't that it was discouraged in any way. It was just that nobody was really pushing me or nurturing that in me. So, you know, I had to get a little bit older before I kind of got my, you know, my grounding, my feet under me, right, where I said, you know what, I'm gonna mess around and try a few things. And so, you know, that's where it started.
So, and this was all in California. So between San Francisco and LA.
Hey, my man, you there?
Yeah, I'm here. Are you hearing me? You hearing me?
Yeah, I lost you for a quick second.
Oh, okay.
There. Yeah.
And this was all in California, LA, San Francisco. All this happened.
My childhood, you know, through high school, I was in San Francisco, and then the LA stuff was, you know, after that, as I got into college. So basically, you know, starting my 20s.
Hashtag happy here saying that I do major concerts in the shower. But here's the thing with hashtag happy,
is
though.
She sending an invitation? What's going on here?
I didn't read that into it, but you know, you could be quicker than I am.
You know, how much are the tickets?
How much are those tickets? Alright, so, but the thing with hashtag happy is, I've heard her sing, and she could really keep a concert. So I don't know what she's talking about, but yeah. 407 welcoming you to the night shift in the pot. Thank you, 407. Go ahead and say thank you to 407.
407, how are you?
Because, you know, we're polite around here.
Yes, sir.
So 3 minutes to the top of the hour. No hashtag
happy. We're just having fun. It's all good.
I always behave. You need to specify how you need me to behave. That is where we come on now. You know better. You
not
know
all
better.
Behavior is good behavior.
All right. So, and welcome, M. I don't know if James Bond is circling somewhere and Q is back in the show, but welcome, M.
Welcome
to the pod. It's 3 minutes to the top of the hour. We're going to take a little break shortly and pay some bills, jump over to our next segment sponsor. Again, big ups to GMAT Music Solutions for sponsoring this segment of the show, bringing music to life. You can check them out. Give them a call, 754-307-GMAC, 754-307-4622. Find out what they can do for you with your live event, or visit them on the website, gmatmusicsolutions.com. Speaking of websites, you have a website, don't you, Tenor Blue?
I do indeed. It is tenorblue.com. Real simple. T-E-N-O-R, like the vocal range, or tenor saxophone,
right.
And blue, the color. So tenorblue.com, and I encourage everybody who's listening to go to my website. I have a mailing list, and if you sign up for it, I will keep you abreast of everything going on in my career and shows, and also get you some free music.
Nice.
That's unreleased. So as a matter of fact, if you sign up, you'll get a tune shot to you right away. So yeah, I got the website and of course the social media thing, and going to keep all that afloat.
Look at that. See? The information that you get right here, straight from, well, I won't say straight from the horse's mouth, but, oh, Marlon changes. I just realized Marlon changed his name to M. Oh, okay. All right, Marlon. I won't associate you with MI6 anymore from this point on. Top of the hour, we're gonna take a quick little break to the blue. Get some friends on over if they so desire to come on, and you can call 774-773-789-STU. 773-789-7839 gets you in touch. You can say hi. You can just hi to Tenor Blue, or you can ask him a burning question. Like I had gotten one earlier, even before the show. Is he single? So, and if not, how long has that been going on? Someone, I guess, I don't know. Resumes coming your way, applications, I don't know. Tenor Blue, I don't know. But, so, questions for you to answer in the next half an hour.
Sounds good.
See, people really want to know who you are. You know, so.
Yeah. Well, and listen, there's no secrets with Tenor Blue.
There you go.
I'm open and willing to share my life, and that's what it's all about. It's a, it's a much more enjoyable vibe when you're not holding things in, and so bring on
that's
the questions.
Right, that's right.
I got answers.
There we go. So jump into the pot, kevinstew.com. The stew pot is there, ready and waiting for you. Or call in 773-789-STEW. You can text also. Don't if you're too shy to talk on the phone, you can text. All right, so if you lose the signal on the site, just go ahead and refresh. It happens from time to time. The technical people on the broadcast side are working on it still. Just refresh. Don't worry about it. We're still here until midnight. All right, so we're going to take a quick little break. We'll be right back.
When being in the moment is priceless, consider the ability to share that moment. If you can video it, you can broadcast it. And Pulse eMedia Group has the tools you need. Weddings, birthdays, funerals, graduations, church services, parties, seminars, you name it. Pulse eMedia Group can provide you with a secure medium controlled by you to broadcast your event. Contact us at www.pulseemediagroup.com for more information.
Pulse Media Group, when being in the moment is priceless.
Hi, this is Cara Manti, and you're listening to DJ Kevin Stew, and this is The Night Shift.
JTMC Music presents the highly anticipated, much talked about, The Juggling Rhythm Volume 1. This classic rhythm takes on a new life with tracks from both established artists and introduces some incredible new voices. Get your dancing shoes ready with The Juggling Rhythm, featuring international reggae dancehall artist Mr. Vegas, alongside Ian Sweetness, Ed Robinson, Jack Radix, Hezron, Danglin, Joanna Marie featuring Galaxy B, Denny Ranks featuring Jawiz, Amber Leek, Christine Alicia, Yishka, also the new sensations on the rhythm, Zeal, Danger Lee, Marquis Skellenard, Zachary, available on all digital media outlets. The Juggling Rhythm. Get it, get it, get it.
I'm in almost every school bus and classroom. You see me around the neighborhood and you tell me that I'm a pretty good kid. Well, I'm one out of every five children in America and I'm struggling with hunger.
Please visit feedingamerica.org today and find your local food bank for ways to help.
Every dollar you donate helps provide 8 meals for kids like me.
We are Feeding America, brought to you by Feeding America and the Ad Council.
Hey, I'm representing for DJ Kevin Stew, working on the night shift, the night shift radio show. Won't go changing like the weather, just to please the devil, never. Will DJ Kevin Stew sell his soul? That's a word and honor. It's Christine representing word and honor. Celestia, DJ Kevin Stew.
Just cool my mind, bad man know the rule my mind. Bad man go on a school my mind, bad man know the tune my mind. Just cool my mind, bad man know the rule my mind. Bad man go on a school my mind, bad man know the tune my mind.
I come from the peer sphere. Killers a million, the villains a play of fear. But number boss and the thug them the peer fear. Babies having babies in at the daycare. Go 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 Gaza at the peer sphere. Tell the wrong class I make your brain wave. Better run fast white in the race fear. Worse than bleach when your block better stay clear. At the place when I show on less the green ready. Only mama them know and respect at Elise Kelly. At the place so them know all the text when I read every on. If you have an issue people magazine ready. But them shoot for your goal if you see messy. Where high grades make you read every. At the place so them preach education is the key. And dreadlocks cannot free any. Just cool my mind, bad man know the rule my mind. Bad man go on a school my mind, bad man know the tool my mind. Just cool my mind, bad man know the rule my mind. Bad man go on a school my mind, bad man know the tool my mind. Just I come from the place that everywhere is a bar.
Cheer shot.
Better stay in the car.
Stay strap.
Everywhere is a church with a prayer sack. Aliens with the white knives. Look at ear jacks. Reach a day with the 9 wide. Cause them ear black. Every girl that them find high. But them hate must disappear. Every guideline to them tear strap.
We learn to hit. Sign of the times that I would turn the page. From a place I'm investing on the march. Cause the man's a revolve from 238. We learn to hit. Chapter all day while I would turn to pray. From a place to them preach. Education is the key. Who lucky to get seem like school right now still.
School no man, bad man know the rule no man.
Bad man go on a school no man, bad man know the tool no man. Just school no man, bad man know the rule no man. Bad man go on a school.
Voila. Yeah, tell your wife from a side where them the mind making hella rise. Genocides and enterprise. Many die at any time. Body fine but never identified, don't mind. When you hype, it's never wise. Got in a nine, go like a nine. And in your life, the fear links a nine. Nine for nine lives, it's a fine life. But when you smile and when you cry, you walk into the pressure, depression in your eyes. I come from a place where death is not a surprise. I come from a place where you make it as a surprise. And many ready for envy and set up for your demise. The mother vendetta you never can rectify. Burn a burn, testify, you never can testify. You never can testify, burn a burn, testify, never testify.
Cool man, bad man know the rule. Bad man go on a school, no man. Bad man know the tool, no man. Just cool.
Zone of Roncos.
No the rule, no man.
Featuring Royal Blue.
School, no man.
Just cool.
Tool, no man.
Just why should I listen when your granny say? Should I
should I listen when the school I say?
You should be listening, you know.
Where is school?
Welcoming you to the segment brought to you by JTMC Enterprise. Big ups to Joanna, Marie, and crew.
Yes, indeed.
For those of you who are just tuning in, we're chatting with Tenor Blue. Not to be mixed up with Royal Blue. Different blue. You heard Royal Blue on this track with Runkus. No, on the line we have Tenor Blue. And we started off the show with Bless Me, which is his first released single.
Mm-hmm.
And the one that he has a single that was just released this past Friday.
Correct.
And you see, this is how things happen in due time, because you were supposed to be on 2 weeks ago and it didn't happen.
Yeah.
And here it is. Now the track has been released officially. I had been playing it because I was privileged enough to get a copy to play it.
Mm-hmm.
And here it is now, it has been released. So now everybody can get it.
And while it's hot.
I was about to say, and while it's still hot. Funny enough,
yes,
that's
sir.
The title of the track.
Yes,
get it while it's hot. But before we get into about the song being hot and getting you while you are hot.
Mm.
I don't know if that was why the question was asked, but the question that was asked before we went into the commercial break. Tenor Blue, is there a Mrs. Blue? Are there tiny blues?
Oh. Well, there's a not so tiny blue, but there is a Mrs. Blue, yes.
Okay.
I actually got married in April of this year, 2018.
Hey.
Yes. Yeah,
condolences. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Friday
so,
sleep.
I'm very happily married. I mean, I'm sure everybody's happily married after 6 months. I'm in a good situation. So, you know, it's interesting,
nice.
Man. You know, it's like, you know, when you're at a juncture in your life where you can see down the road and where the career appears to be going, you know?
Right.
But you know that, you know, when you get to a place where things are going well and, you know, you're out there in the public eye and, you know, the things that can come with that. But, you know, the truth is that, you know, we talked earlier about, you know, who is Tenor Blue, and I'm a lover, you know what I mean? And I believe in marriage. I believe in the institution of marriage. I believe that, you know, God calls a man and a woman to be companions and be together and be one flesh. And, you know, that in all things in life, you can't have everything, you know, you can't have the peace and the security and the joy
of
marriage and have, you know, be running around and have a lot of women and, you know, and doing all that. So, you know, the thing is that, and I think the main thing is when you get into a relationship, you have to find the right person, you know, who compliments you. And so, you know, the thing is, you know, with all that I have going on right now, to have peace and love and stability in the home is very meaningful to me.
Right.
And, I'm blessed to have a good woman by my side who supports what I'm doing. And so, you know, the answer is yes. I am married and it's a good situation. And then I have a son who's not a little tot. He's a, you know, young teenager.
Oh, nice.
And he's the light of my life. You know what I mean? He's a superstar of a kid. But, you know, and that's part of my story because, you know, I'm not 25 years old. I'm not just breaking into the business as a kid. And part of the deal is, you know, this is not my first incarnation in the business.
Oh, okay.
We were talking earlier about, you know, how I got started in music, yeah. but that whole thing in LA, built up and led to a record contract, many years ago with a subsidiary of RCA Records. So I was in, you know, signed to a, you know, a subsidiary of a major label.
Yes. Yeah.
And went through the development of an album project, which unfortunately got shelved. But you know, I've been here in South Florida for, you know, 15 years now.
Okay.
And so I've been making music, but one of the things that happened with me was that I split from my son's mother when he was a young child, because it was the right thing to do at that time.
Mm.
And, you know, I got to a place where I could see the possibility of a really legitimate career in music, but I didn't feel comfortable going on the road and leaving my son alone with his mother for months at a time. And, you know, she's a very loving mom, but I just felt like he needed me in his life.
Right,
to have strength and stability. And so I backed off of what I was doing in music to be here and be present for him.
Right.
And, you know, now he's at a stage where he's got, you know, a solid foundation. He's a great kid. He's doing really well in school. He's bright. He's, you know what I mean? So,
right.
And what happens is, you know, God came back to me and he spoke to my heart and he said, it's time for you to get back in the game and, you know, start doing your thing again. And so this is where I'm at right now. So, you know, I'm blessed to have found a good woman who you know, who's a part of my life. And I've got my son who's, you know, he's getting big and, you know, is able to take care of himself a little bit. And so the time is right. You know, everything happens in due season.
Does she like reggae music, your wife? Does she like reggae music?
She does. She's from Brazil. And so she's, you know, she's new in this country as of about a year ago. And she does like reggae. I mean, she likes all kinds of music, you know, but did she grow up or was she accustomed to listening to reggae music, some Brazilian reggae, and there is definitely reggae in Brazil,
yes.
But it's not Jamaican reggae. So this whole thing, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Singing Alton Ellis tunes, and this is all new to her. But the funny thing is now she knows these songs, you know? She's
nice.
Like, well, familiar. Yeah, so she definitely appreciates reggae music.
I have a song that I'll play for her a little bit later on.
Okay.
So you speak Portuguese?
I do not.
That is interesting.
You know, she speaks English quite well. And I would love to learn Portuguese. But, you know, it's tough. Like, I don't know, you know, if there's anybody out there that's been or is in a marriage or a relationship with somebody whose native tongue is different than English, you know, if they speak English, it's like you have to really commit to learning that language, or you have to say, you know, we're going to take 2 days a week and we're not going to speak English in the house. And I'm going to, you know,
right,
fight through it. And it's just, it hasn't happened. And, you know, the thing is, I've got so much going on and with the music stuff. And it's like, you know, maybe one day we'll get to that. In the meantime, I'm learning a few words here and there.
Nice.
You know,
that's a lot of hats tipping to you right now. You know, the taking the time off to put your stuff on the back burner and focus on your son. Big ups to you with that, and applause coming to you in the pot also.
I appreciate it.
To your commitment to being a father, that's superb. And then here you are. So you are a white American singing reggae music. married to a Portuguese, well, Portuguese speaking Brazilian.
Yeah. Let me tell you what, there are not two Tenor Blues in this world.
Listen, there probably needs to be. you covering all these bases.
Yeah,
you know, that's something.
I'm a different type of a dude, you know. I mean, it's like, which is great. It's great. I mean, listen, everybody, we're all created different, you know,
definitely,
by God. And, you know, and the thing is, you know, it's just about getting into and expressing your individuality and kind of, you know, just owning who you are or who God's called you to be. And, you know, again, what makes us who we are, who knows? You know, it's a mystery. But, you know, and life is a journey, and I've certainly been on one. But, you know, I love what I do, and I, you know, I can't tell you how and why all this stuff happens and how I ended up with the woman I did and how I, you know, became a reggae singer or what attracted me to it all. But it is what it is, and I love it and I embrace it. And, you know, you make the most of it and you, you know, you give it your all and see what happens.
Marlon says you're a well-rounded guy. I got a message on the text line saying very honorable to put your son first. Big ups.
Yeah.
Indeed.
You know, I mean, it is what it is, man. You know, it's, you do these things out of love, you know? It's
right.
Anybody who's a parent, hopefully knows, you know, it's like you don't put yourself first. You know what I mean? Your kid comes first in all things.
Yeah.
So, you know, it's, and I look at the situation, I have no regrets because I feel like right now, you know, my writing, my creativity, my voice, my everything feels right today.
Right.
You know, much more so than it ever had in the past. So, you know, for whatever reason, you know, I feel like God is blessing me now, or he's opening the doors for me now. And that's been part of the equation is, you know, when I heard that voice inside myself,
mm-hmm.
a couple years ago saying, get back in the game, get back in the music. You know, it was one of these things where it was like, I have to start opening the door,
right,
and seeing what's on the other side, you know. And I told God, I said, listen, if it's meant to be, you'll let me know.
Right.
And just, you know, I'm going to open the door and you tell me where I'm supposed to go. And if, you know, if I should be doing this or not doing this or whatever. And when I did that, it was like green lights. One after the other, after the other, after the other. And it's, you know, continued to be this way. So, you know, I just continue to step forward and do my thing. And, you know, as long as it continues like this, I'm loving it. I'm enjoying it. And at the end of the day, it's really just about sharing music with the world, you know, and, you know, sharing your gift with other people and touching people's hearts. And, you know, that's what it's all about.
I remember a little over a year ago, it could have been, or just about a year ago, again in the garden, and you came off the stage, and I had introduced myself to you then.
Mm-hmm.
I had given you my card, and I asked you if you have any material, and you said, well, I'm doing some work with J Vibe.
Mm-hmm.
I'm like, what? Okay, cool. Then if you're working with J Vibe,
like instant legitimacy right there.
That too. I'm like, well, if you're doing some things with him, then I should be getting some things coming down the pipeline.
Yeah.
What are is one of these two tracks work from? Working with J Vibe?
Yeah, so the new tune, Get It While It's Hot, is. The track is actually a Willie Chin, Black Chinee track.
Mm-hmm. right,
that Jay Vibe has produced the song.
Mm-hmm.
And there's more coming out for sure from my project with Jay Vibe. But what ended up happening was this, I kind of had to take a step back because the opportunity to work with Jay Vibe presented itself. And I jumped on that opportunity, which was originally I was hoping to maybe get a tune or two done with him. And he offered me the chance to do an album with him. And so I felt like I had to take it, you know, a guy of his caliber as a producer and somebody could help, you know, take some of my ideas and my songs to the next level. I was there.
Yes.
So, but when we got towards the finish line on that project, you know, you basically realize, okay, well, how am I going to get this stuff out there? Right. So now I'm coming back into the music business and nobody really knows me, certainly not on, you know, maybe on a local level, but not on a national or international level.
Right.
And so you start to think about, okay, well, how am I going to get this music out there and start to break through? And the music business has changed a lot, you know, and it's a singles market. So I started looking at, well, what's the song and how am I going to break it? And, you know, without a team and so on and so forth. So I started to really get into the business side of things because I knew that that was going to be important in order to, you know, not just make music, but to actually develop a career.
Right.
And so, you know, and in the same time that all this is happening, I'm writing, I'm recording, I'm working on stuff. So, you know, I got to know Vinnie Hamilton down here, and he and I started working on a couple tunes. Mm-hmm. So Vinnie produced Bless Me. And it was just, you know, one of the things that
Vinny's
thought was,
real,
you know,
cool guy.
Yeah, real cool guy. So the one of the things you want to do as an artist when you start to release music is define who you are as a human being and as an artist.
Right.
And I felt Bless Me was a good song to do that, you know, and I was Excellent. Proud of the writing in that song. And, you know, I think that song sort of establishes who I am in my heart, you know. My love for people, you know, mm-hmm. my belief in relationships and love and digging into that, you know what I mean, and not running away from love. And also, if you listen to the lyrics, I think it gives you some insight into kind of who I am as a human being. So I said, let's go with this tune, and then Get It While It's Hot was kind of the natural number two. I can't Get It While It's Hot as a tune that's got to be one of the first records. You know what I mean? That's not something you drive 2-3 years down the road.
What's the story behind it? What's the story behind Get It While It's Hot?
You know, there really is no story, to be honest with you. You know, sometimes you just write something and it just comes out. You know, who knows? Yeah. Listen, every song is a gift from the creator, and how they come and why they come. And say, you know, sometimes it's just a hard question to answer, Kevin.
Yeah.
But you know, at one point that song came to me, and a lot of it is, you know, sometimes I write songs with a guitar. Sometimes I hear a melody. I'm driving down the road and I get an idea, or I hear a melody and I create and build that into a song that I then go to a producer or other musicians and help to develop, or I come back and I figure out the chord progression on the guitar. And then in other cases, people give me tracks. Mm. So in the case of Get It While It's Hot, the track was given to me. And when I get a track from a producer, every track has its own vibe and its own energy. So I try to listen to what the track is telling me. And in that case, that's what the track told me. Get it while it's hot.
There you go.
It's fresh. So it's a different type of a tune from a lot of the stuff that I've done. But I love it, you know, because it is what it is. And it's a good sort of an introductory song for an artist trying to break through and find his way and sort of, you know, pull out the megaphone and let the world know, here I come.
Yeah, that's definitely a you know, watch out, here I come kind of a song. It says a lot. It says all the things that a lot of people trying to break out in whatever era they're trying to break out in want to see. But for some reason they're holding back or they're afraid to say it. But the reality is, listen, get me now when either I am free or I am cheap. Because there's going to come a time when you're going to have to take out installments or take out a second mortgage to afford me. And it's not being cocky. It is being confident. It is knowing where you want to be and placing value on what you do.
I appreciate that. And that is the sentiment of the song for sure. And it's a bold statement, but I certainly don't want it to come across as cocky, because I don't think that's where I'm at as a human being.
No.
But you're right. You know, having confidence in your skills as an artist in whatever it is that you do, right?
Yeah.
That you're stepping out in the world and letting people know, here I am, I'm ready.
And if you're not putting value on your stuff, nobody else is going to do it either.
Correct.
So it has to start right there with making that statement. And this song here, I believe that you made the statement, and it's a legit statement.
Mm.
Those that saw you perform at VP Live, I wasn't able to make it there, but I was watching live on via social media. And so if anybody listening did not get a chance to catch him live, you want to look that up. You look for him on social media. You can look for the VP Live Showcase hashtags. You could look for it on the Joanna Marie JTMC. You can look for it on my social media on Facebook, because I shared it. So it's out there. Tenor Blue is out there. Just put in Tenor Blue on Facebook and you're definitely guaranteed to find the live.
Yeah. So it's a fun song to perform. It's a high energy tune.
Yeah.
It gets people up out of their seats, and you know, it's it feels good. It feels good. I love performing.
What is in store coming down the line? What are some of the things?
Yeah, that's a great question. So there's a lot in store. I've built a little team around me. You know, I want to give shout outs to Joanna Marie on the marketing, Rockwell. I've been working with Wendy Morgan and Mal on PR, MPR consulting.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, basically what's going on is I've got a slew of singles kind of lined up, and it's not perfectly defined as to what's going to drop when just yet, because we are at the end of 2018,
right?
And we kind of made a quick rush to get it while it's hot out. You know, that was really Rockwell encouraging me to push that song forward, which I think was the right move, and I appreciate
that very
much. But I've got a song, another J Vibe production that features Peter Morgan from Morgan Heritage, which is and it's a conscious tune, right?
Mm-hmm,
it's a deep tune. It's got very heavy subject matter, but I think it'll speak to people. That's coming down the pike. And I've got some tunes that are kind of crossover tunes, but the end game is really just to, with each single that gets released, to kind of up the ante and raise the bar and build awareness about me and to build my audience and my following, to get to a point where there's enough of a buzz and people are anticipating either an EP or an LP, depending upon what we have in pocket that we feel is appropriate and right. And that's probably something that, looking at either, you know, spring or early summer of 2019, to drop a larger project, at least an 8-song project.
Right.
Yeah.
You ever thought of doing any other genres of music?
Okay. So, everybody buckle up. because the real deal is this, you know, and we've been talking here for a good hour, you know, my background, my roots mm-hmm. is in American music and soul music. And that, you know, if you see me perform, you see me sing, you hear my music, certainly a tune like Bless Me, you can hear that R&B, that soul vibe in
yeah.
it. And so, you know, one of the things that I've always seen myself as is not a reggae artist, but an international music artist. And what I do is I take reggae mm-hmm. and I blend it with R&B and I blend it with international music and I throw in a little dash of jazz and there's a little bit of pop in there. And, you know, and yes. so, you know, really what I want to do is I want to reach a very wide audience of people all over the world. So what you're going to see from me very soon is some records that are not reggae records, but you can hear you can hear Tenor Blue and you yeah. can hear that reggae vibe deep underneath the surface. But I have some stuff that I'm working on that's more, you know, there's stuff that's kind of crossover dancehall, Afro pop vibe, R&B hip hop flavor to it. And you might even hear some kind of, you know, Cali style reggae, you know, a little bit more what I would call white reggae. but the thing is that you'll always hear me. You'll always hear my voice and my right. vibe. And what I try to do is I pull these things together in a way that is natural mm-hmm, and mm-hmm. feels right. So yes, absolutely, definitely is the answer to your question.
Nice.
Yeah.
Looking forward to that.
Yeah.
Because, so you are the second artist that I have spoken to that does not live in a reggae music pocket. The other artist is actually a group, Wild Tree,
mm-hmm.
and they mentioned how their background is also not, their foundation is not in reggae music. So we're looking for things coming out of them that is not just reggae music also.
Yeah.
So I'm loving the direction that artists like you and Wild Tree and other South Florida artists that I've come in contact with. I like yeah. the direction that you're going, because not only does it allow you to reach various genres, but it allows various genres to get closer to reggae.
Yes, for sure. You know, yeah,
sorry.
Man, that you're spot on. You're spot on with this. And, you know, I really want to have some crossover tunes.
Yeah.
I think, you know, one of the things, like, you know, we're having this conversation, Kevin, and just,
yeah.
you know, putting stuff on the table. I'm a Christian, right? Mm-hmm, I'm a follower mm-hmm. of Jesus Christ, and that's
yeah.
that's foundational in my life, right? So, you know, on what we're talking about, you know, I could have chosen to do faith-based music.
Right.
But my thing with faith-based music is that you're singing to an audience that's already, they're already believers, right?
Mm.
They're already on the train. But how do you get people who aren't to open their ears and open their hearts and open their minds to something that they wouldn't otherwise? And the only way you can do that is if you're coming from a secular angle, but you're throwing that element into what you're doing. And by the same token, what you're talking about, right? It's how do you take reggae? I mean, and I'm not the first to do this, right?
Yeah.
I mean, you know, there's
meet the people
so
where
many
they are.
Artists. There's, yeah, I mean, there's been hip-hop artists. There's Maxi Priest. There's, you know, I mean, there's been many, 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 many artists who have and continue to fuse reggae with other styles. I think the thing that's a little bit different about me is that there's a lot of white reggae artists out there today in groups
mm-hmm.
that are doing reggae, but there aren't really white reggae artists that are keeping that soulful element
mm.
in the reggae, right?
Yeah.
And then where they're Americans and they're fusing it with a little dash of hip hop and a little dash of R&B and a little dash of jazz and, you know, these traditional American art forms. Most of the white reggae artists out there today are doing, you know, they're doing kind of, I don't know, hippie reggae or, you know, it's a lot of it is about, there's beach reggae, you know, there's kind of weed smoking reggae, tree hugging reggae. I'm not demeaning any of this because it's high quality music,
yeah,
but that's
yeah.
not my lane. That's not my angle.
Right.
You know?
Right.
So, you know, what I want to do is just, you know, what I do, which is based and rooted in the music that I grew up with and that I love, and kind of bringing everything together. And, you know, I've had conversations with some people who are in the business who I respect highly. Mm-hmm. And one of the things that you try to do as an artist or you want to do is to create something that is different from what everybody else is doing.
Yes.
So that, you know, there's so much music out there today, right?
Yeah.
Because there's so many independent artists and it's so easy to put music out there.
Yeah.
But how do you do something that it's like, well, people have to come to you as an artist to get that, to get that sound. Or that vibe, or that they can't get it anywhere else,
right.
You know? And that's the challenge from the standpoint of being a writer and an artist is how do you create something that's really unique where you have a unique voice? And that's, you know, that's the goal. That's the holy grail.
You do it with a little help from friends.
You do it with help from friends and you do it really honestly with help from the Most High,
yeah.
You know, because if you humble your heart and you know,
yeah.
And you're willing to look within yourself, you know, and be introspective mm-hmm. and try to create something that's honest, that comes from the heart. I mean, that gets back to, you know, we're all unique as human beings, right? You know, it's not chasing after what's being played on top 40 radio or being played on, you know, the typical reggae station, but who are you? Who are you as a human being? Who are you as an artist? And get into that mm-hmm. and just do that and embrace that and be that and let the magic come out.
Right. Hashtag Happy says, and this was why I laughed earlier. Okay, you've talked me into it. I'll do it with you.
Come on, Happy. Let's get it done. Where are you at? I got the studio fired up. Come on over.
You know what? Since she had put it out there, hashtag Happy, I'm challenging you. Tenor Blue has a studio. He's ready. You put it out there. Now you're going to have to do it. There it is.
Well, let's go. First off, who is Happy? I must know, because I know I've met Happy, I'm sure.
You have, but hashtag Happy.
Who is Happy? What's Happy's real first name?
I think Happy should call, like, right now.
Come on, Happy. Let's get it cracking. Let's go. We need to raise the bar here.
Yeah, let's do just that. Let's raise the bar. Hashtag Happy. I know Marlon is over there just dying right now.
You know what else? We got to get Happy. Happy needs to sing a tune.
Oh my
God. On air.
Ooh.
I want to hear this voice.
Well, you're not scared. Call Happy. Call. Here we go. Call. You know she's putting it in there. I ain't scared. Call. You know the numbers. Call.
Oh, it's Melody. I know Happy. Come on now. Let's hear this voice.
Oh my goodness. You see, you can't hide. Not that she's trying to hide. She does the happy, so nobody can really mistake her. It's the one and only
know Happy, and she is happy.
Yes,
she's got a light countenance about her.
Yes, she does, and the voice that goes along with her. Oh my goodness!
Really? Okay. This is new news to Tenor Blue.
And here we go. Hold on. Here we go. Good evening. Welcome to. I can't even welcome you to the show because. Hashtag happy. Hey, Mal.
I'm telling you, I can't have one show where I can just sit down and listen. No. I get called out.
Kevin makes you call every time. Is that right?
Every time. This has to stop.
So here it is. I'm well into my musical therapy time, but still this is therapy nonetheless. So here we have an honorary Jamaican in hashtag happy and an honorary Jamaican in Tenor Blue from the reggae music standpoint. And I don't know how management will feel about this, but it has been put out there in the universe. So, Melody, you can't get away from it now. Along with your book, people are expecting a duet with Tenor Blue. So.
I guess I have to be careful what I say. I really
yeah.
So you two are no strangers to each other. Melody, Tenor Blue, Melody.
Of course.
Listen, we have nothing but time, and the Father knows best, and He has given you both talents and both voices. He has given me the platform to play the production, so you do it, let me play it, and here we go.
That sounds good.
So, now...
We'll figure it out. We'll figure it out, Melody, because... Maybe we can do something live. Maybe we can do something on stage together.
Honestly...
We'll talk about it offline. I don't know if this is. Yeah.
They have pulled you into the dark side.
I'm open. We'll figure it out.
Ladies and gentlemen, you've heard it here first.
Oh my God.
So, see, this is what you asked about in the song. This is what you asked for in the song. Bless me. Here it is, Tenor Blue. There. Blessings. Blessings on top of blessings on top of blessings.
Blessing with a smile. I see you.
There it is. Melody, thank you very much. Tenor Blue, thank you. Give out your social media for me, please, Tenor Blue.
Yeah, absolutely. So, main social media platforms I'm working with are Instagram, Facebook, and a little dabbling on Twitter, and it's all at Tenor Blue Music. Music spelled how it's supposed to be spelled, M-U-S-I-C. Tenor Blue Music, at Tenor Blue Music. So I encourage everybody to come and check me and communicate with me and direct message me and whatever.
Nice.
I'm a man of the people. I like to talk to people, and I like to respond to any questions or whatever it is that you have to say. So reach out to me. I would love it. And that's it. And then tenorblue.com is the other place to come catch me.
There you go. And you do want to catch him while he's hot.
That's what's got to happen.
Thank you very much, hashtag happy, for putting that in the chat, in the pot. Tenorblue.com. That's a place to be.
Nice. I appreciate that. Melody, thank you for joining us. Next time I see you, we will talk about a duet.
There we go.
We'll see what's really happening.
I'm going to learn to stop putting stuff in the scatterer.
Well, you know what? When we started this whole conversation, we were offline, Kevin and I were, and he was letting me know that he's a musician and some of the cats that he plays with. So maybe we'll do this as a jam session, a private jam session.
That sounds good. Okay.
That sounds good.
So no, you're dragging me into this, huh?
That's right. We will not go alone.
See, that'll teach me to invite you to call.
And then we'll live to tell the tale.
All right, listen. Musical therapy. I have 13 minutes of it, and we're going to kick it off. We'll get it while it's hot. Tenor Blue, you have to introduce this song. Melody, thank you very much for spreading the hashtag happy.
You're quite welcome. Thank you.
All right. So,
yeah, this is my brand new single, hot off the press, fresh for the world. Get it while it's hot. The song speaks for itself. Check it out. I hope you enjoy it. It's out there on every streaming platform. I don't care where you listen to music, YouTube, Spotify, SoundCloud, wherever, iTunes. Go get the song, stream it, buy it, I don't care what. It's free, and I want you to enjoy it. That's what it's there for. So here we go. Get it while it's hot.
Time to get it like the present.
Get it while it's cheap, maybe even free.
Get it while it's hot. The son of Tenor Blue. And this is a musical therapy segment brought to you by the Wake Up and Live show. Sir Rockwell kicked it off at 7 a.m. tomorrow, rotterbox.net. That's right, hashtag happy. Marlon, you're joining us on bass. You see, Tenor Blue, I left you alone with the guitar part, you know. You mentioned fooling around with the guitar. I left it alone this time. But you're not escaping. I put the guitar out there in the universe. Tenor Blue plays the guitar, y'all. I thought I missed it, huh?
Oh, man. Now I'm feeling like Melody.
Right. There you go. So Marlon on bass, Tenor Blue lead vocals and guitar. Okay, since I'm dragged in there, I will play the drums. Listen,
catch us.
Wait till next year. Although this may happen just in next year. Tenor Blue, thank you very much, bro. Truly appreciate love it. Truly appreciate love you.
Yo, man, I appreciate you, DJ Kevin Stu. This has been a pleasure. I enjoyed myself thoroughly, and I will come back anytime you tell me to.
Yes, sir. The platform is always here for you, bro.
All right, good.
All right, take care, man.
I love you. You
blessings.
Too. Blessings. Good night. Thank you, everybody, for joining. I appreciate you and look forward to sharing much, much more music with you. God bless you.
All right. Blessings, man.
Get it while it's hot, get it while it's fresh, get it while it's new and hot off the press. Never settle for less, no. Get it while it's cheap, maybe even free, cause next time around you're paying good money to come and see we. Get it while it's hot, get it while it's fresh, get it while it's new and hot off the press.
And I told Tenor Blue that I'll be playing a song for his wife.
Hot off the press.
Which birthday jam, Marlon? Melody's birthday jam? Is that my sister from another Mr. Melissa Lady song? Oh, Melissa. Okay, cool, gotcha. Hiding over there in the wings. I wonder which Melissa that is. Don't know, that's another question. Which Melissa? This is the song that I said I'd be playing for Tenor Blue's wife. This is Mauricio Diaz. The track is called Salvio Rey. One third of Wild Tree. Big ups to you, Melissa. Hey, Melly Mel. Who doesn't celebrate all month? Hashtag happy. Come on now. This is Mauricio Diaz. Salvio Rey. Translated, save the king.
Saudade dos seus filhos, mandou seus mensageiros, leve sua carta, percorre em todos os lugares, em frente aos rios e mares. Oh, suba os montes, desça os penhascos, clame em voz alta até que seja ouvido o que o rei tem escrito. Ele sente falta dos seus filhos, encontrados serão o que se havia perdido. Mas o rei chora, chora, chora por cada um de nós, vim de todos vós cansados, oprimido, criança, jovem, velho. Deixe os seus prazeres, voltemos juntos a alegrar o coração do vosso rei, do vosso rei, do vosso rei. Rei, louve ao rei, celebre ao rei, vim de todos vós cansados, oprimidos. O vosso rei vos aliviará, o vosso rei vos aliviará. Rei, louve ao rei, celebre ao rei, vim de todos vós cansados, oprimidos. O vosso rei vos aliviará, o vosso rei vos aliviará.
I guess we're gonna be celebrating for a few months musically then, huh?
Mandou seus mensageiros, leve sua carta.
November,
decorre em todo
December,
Paris,
January,
rios e mares. Oh, suba os montes, desça os penhascos, clame em voz alta até que seja ouvido o que o rei tem escrito. Ele sente falta dos seus filhos, encontrados serão que se havia perdido. Mas o rei chora, chora, chora por cada um de nós, vim de todos vós cansados, oprimido, criança, jovem, velhos. Deixe os seus prazeres, voltemos juntos a alegrar o coração do vosso rei, do vosso rei, do vosso rei. Rei, louve ao rei, celebre ao rei, vim de todos vós cansados, oprimidos. O vosso rei vos aliviará, o vosso rei vos aliviará. Rei, louve ao rei, celebre ao rei, vim de todos vós cansados, oprimidos. O vosso rei vos aliviará, o vosso rei vos aliviará. O vosso rei vos aliviará. Oh glória. Salve o rei.
Hear me tell us. You're so spiteful, girl. Every
Cause if me never break away and go make away, me know me heart would have burn up like a craven.
This is the sound of King Charles.
Should I listen to the words me say? So me tell yourself to move on. And me say don't come back you now. You only love me cause you know the thing.
If you were at Jerkfest last night, yesterday, you'd have heard King Charles doing lead vocals at one point with Code Red Band and performing this song.
Because you don't know who you want to be. It a go bon. You should have never diss the eye. You know you see. It a go bon. You just want to say you're good.
Didn't even realize I didn't change my image.
You know me nah give you no apology. Because you never love me and me now.
I want to thank you all for tuning in tonight.
Enough to make it show. Well watch you now. My girl you're too slow. Wait. But I just saw the story go. So me tell yourself it. Move on and me say don't come back you now. You only love me cause you know the thing shot you now. Move on, me should have never tied the knot you know. I know the fire go burn you like a pot you know. Move on and me say don't come back you know. You only love me cause you know the thing shot you know. Move on, me should have never tied the knot you know. I know the fire go burn you like a pot you know. You be say me are your king and you know what fi be me queen. Up and live a dream, but I dream you a dream like all in. But what you know, I give you all my love. But you throw me out away, throw me out away. Me see clear, say you cruff your wants. And I say don't know when you hear me chant. So me tell yourself it. Move on and me say don't come back you know. You only love me cause you know it.
Much respect Marlon.
Move on, me should have never tied the knot you know.
Want to invite you all to come back tomorrow at 10 to midnight Eastern. Sean Garrity joins me for Healthy Love. Good night, good morning, good afternoon, good day to you, wherever you are in the world. I'm out of here. Remember, Sir Rockwell kicks it off tomorrow morning at 7 with the Wake Up and Live show. And he goes until 11. And at midday, Clinton Lindsay takes it over on the Foundation Radio Network. All being well, little Gary should be up around about 7 p.m. with Island Rockers. Mr. Lady Song will be on at 9 on Facebook Live, the latest song show, soon to migrate from Facebook Live to theladiesongshow.com. So you want to get in touch with her right now on social media, see when that is happening, and make sure you stay following. Ladies and gentlemen, DJ Kevin Stew, this is a night shift. Happens every Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday night, 10 to midnight. I'm out of here. Take care.
When being in the moment is priceless, consider the ability to share that moment. If you can video it, you can broadcast it. And Pulse eMedia Group has the tools you need. Weddings, birthdays, funerals, graduations, church services, parties, seminars, you name it. Pulse eMedia Group can provide you with a secure medium controlled by you to broadcast your event. Contact us at www.pulseemediagroup.com for more information. Pulse eMedia Group, when being in the moment is priceless.